So, in the built-in game, without any mods, there are 6 countries to pick from. There are tons of mods in the workshop. I just have them disabled because there's a new expansion that came out, and I wanted to make sure nothing was breaking nothing. So, felt safer to do that. Hey, Nerd Wonder. Some of the mods add nations, some of them add more decisions and stuff. A lot of fun. I'm playing with all 4 expansions that are currently out. Those are the mods I have now, is the 4 official expansions. So, Lazarus, thank you very much for the resub. We did a poll at the start to see who would play as. It was actually a 3-way race between the UK, USA, and Germany for a while there. But the UK did pull ahead right at the end, and it'll be fun to play. Who's that? Who is true? Because that's not actually true. It's a broken bug thing. Tiburon, thank you very much for the resub. Who was right before Tiburon? Artorias with the resub. Thank you very much, Artorias. Still don't know why that bug happens. I still have to find a new type of software, I guess, for my pop-ups. Hey, Laudrian. So we're going to be playing sort of a post-Brexit UK. Basically, we're going to have a country that, hey, Enderil, that is more isolationist. I think I'll leave the sliders where they are, but we're going to make decisions that are more isolationist. So we're going to be I don't think that's who's actually in charge, but hey, Crispy Goff, we're going to be the UKIP party. I think that makes sense, right? You quit. And I don't know, we're gonna be up against the People's Popular Front, just to pick something. Who's this true? Now I don't know. That's probably Deku. No, it wasn't. I don't even know who it is. I don't know the pop-ups. Final Boss, thank you very much for the resub. Ah, and right before that, we had RoboJeb. RoboJeb, one of our favorite mods for Kerbal Space Program, which we do have to play again. So yes, we're gonna be the You Quit party. Or You Quit, that would be good too. The You Quit party. There, You Quit the EU Quit party. I'm gonna spell it lowercase like that. It's a You Quit party. I'm sure other people have made that joke too. Punisher, thank you very much for the 2-year resubiversary. Bum 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 bum. Deku, there it is. There's Deku with the 16-month one as well. That name too real. The You Quit party. And we're going to be up against the People's Popular Front. So, in most parliamentary things, there's no term limit because prime ministers don't really work the same way as presidents. Crucio, thank you very much for the resub. So, we're going to leave the things as a default. We've got a monarchy in here. I don't think I'm going to mess with these sliders at all. I mean, maybe we'll be somewhat more conservative as opposed to liberal from the baseline UK settings in this game. Hey, Boston. And we'll leave the socialism where it is. Azinthia, hello and welcome for the Twitch Babyversary. All right. The what could possibly go wrong party. Oh, Dudok, that would have been pretty funny. Kruyan! One of my, what's the game called? XCOM people! Hey! Oh, the EU is awesome party's opposition would have been funny, actually. Yamzo! Thank you very much for the resub as well. Do earthquakes? Well, the UK is not really known for their earthquakes. Are we having problems, this usually means it's glitched. I may have to do like a clean install. There might be some old mod shit still left in here. Because this is normally very fast to load. This to me says something is wrong. I had loaded a game first, which worked fine, and then I didn't quit the game completely between runs. Hey, Scott. Hey, Rexig. So let me just start over again and see how that goes. New game, United Kingdom. We're going to be the EU quit party. And we're gonna be up against the EU Rocks party. There we go. We're gonna do that. Again, I'll bring this down just a scooch. Hit play. Now one. Kena, thank you very much for the resub. Alright. Congratulations on your election victory! Welcome to your new job as Prime Minister. Everything is effed. The lives of all 63 million citizens are now in your hands. As you imagine, the number of situations, concerns, blah, 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 blah. Things are broken. We've got serious crimes. In fact, we even have vigilante mobs going around, which is pretty nuts. We have organized crime going on. We have a doctor strike. Oh, I'm not used to dealing with that shit. That's terrible. Asthma epidemic. Everyone's always got that. Alcohol abuse. I mean, at that point, it's no longer alcohol abuse. Everything is so broken. You've got no choice but to drink your worries away. We have an uncompetitive economy right now. We have a homelessness problem. And down here we have we're technology backwater? Really? Alright, sure, that's fine. Damn username, thank you very much for the resub. Geek Scott, I'm sorry I missed your sub. Shanix with the resub as well. And we got our first donation explosion today. Thanks for the tip, friend zone forever. How was your family thing after your last stream, Quill? I cooked a recipe for fried chicken yesterday. It's 40 years older than America. It was published in England in 1736. That's crazy. The family thing was awesome. Had a lovely time hanging out with my parents for a day. My sister was her birthday as well. So we got together, we had some good food, and that was lovely. And I just got back late last night. So, Raram, thank you very much for the resub. And I know we're going to be missing some now that we're playing Michael. Before that, thank you very much. All the tech was from the EU. Yeah. Where's the immigration problem? All right, Brexit fixed that. Well, you're true. I mean, we actually don't have... We have street gangs, ghettos, organized crime. We don't currently actually have... we need, like, a mod to add, like, you know, immigration problems or something like that that we're looking to solve in this post-Brexit world. Tamfoolery, thank you very much for the sub. Welcome to the party. So right now, we have, you know, we do have immigration. We have border controls are currently set to biometric checks. I mean, we can go and crank that way up. That's one of the things we could do to represent the fact that we are kind of anti-immigration at this point. Obviously, foreign relations, you know, we might put in some rules. We could just pass some new laws. That would be under... So probably not foreign policy is what we're looking for. Is it law and order, maybe? Like, there are some more things we can definitely pass. There, racial profiling. To represent the sort of, you know, closed border isolationism that a post-Brexit UK might be heading towards, for example. Set up an illegal private email server. Well, I'm not playing as America. I mean, that'd be crazy. Immigration problems, build a wall. Check prison laws. Prison laws, yeah. Would this be prisons? Right now we have basic provisions. Extensive rehabilitation, which would lower crime, make the liberals happy. Does cost a lot more money, though. More state employees. And another tip just came in. Who's that from? Hamlin. Consider me a lobbyist for lower drinking ages and more available firearms. What? Okay, first of all, we should check that. What is our... Right now, the minimum age of 18. Could drop that to 16 or no limits on alcohol consumption. I mean, we already have a max-out alcohol abuse problem. It's not like the alcohol abuse could get worse. Which is interesting to consider. It does make our state health services more expensive. It increases crime and lowers health, which is all very, very bad. But it can't actually get any worse. Which is pretty funny. The UK's already got a wall. It's called an ocean. let's see. What are we going to do here? Like, let's take a look at our finances. Right now, we do run a deficit of 11 billion pounds per quarter. Hey, Cobalt Duck, thanks for the resub. And that's actually not so bad as a percentage of our current income and expenditures. We're actually... close to balanced, which is kind of nice. We do have a huge amount of debt. We take a look at our expenses. Okay, right now the state health services and pensions are our biggest expense. And our debt interest is actually quite low. Which is nice. Now our debt interest will obviously go up, but financially we're not that hard up right now, which is kind of surprising. I do often like to deal with something like technological backwater is really bad. It does lower the GDP. GDP is our gross domestic product, it's how much money we make overall, and this directly affects how many taxes we bring in. It's being brought down by crime, our low productivity, a little bit by immigration status right now, and the uncompetitive economy and technology backwater. One of the best ways to alleviate uncompetitive economy and technology backwater, and indirectly as well, our productivity, is all through better education and better technology. That really kind of snowballs together to improve our economy pretty substantially. On the other hand, all this crime is really, really, really hurting things. One of the best ways to help reduce some crime is a community police initiative, which is incredibly cheap and shockingly effective. Increase funding for football manager. Yeah, right, the red one. That's an excellent idea. Max out alcohol consumption, no age limit, and then max the alcohol tax. That is really funny, actually. Now, increasing the alcohol tax does dramatically decrease alcohol consumption, but it also hurts the poor and increases poverty. Because anything that is basically sort of a sales tax, which is this, as opposed to an income tax, hurts poor more because more of their income, more of their money, goes towards buying goods, which means they are disproportionately affected by like VAT, you know, value-added tax in you know, any tax on products as opposed to tax on income or savings or something like that, disproportionately affects the poor. So this will create more poor and will make them angry. But it does lower alcohol consumption, and but it makes a lot of money. Like right now, we are making £6 billion a quarter from this. We could easily eliminate our deficit simply through alcohol tax, which is interesting to consider. If you haven't played this before, by the way, one of the things, and I keep reverting, I'm not making the changes, one of the things we have access to here is political capital. This is how much ability we have to affect change, and it's based on the loyalty of our cabinet and various things like that. The new features, by the way, are over here, electioneering. We've got the parties. We can make a manifesto. We have to make that closer to the actual election time. We can make speeches. Fundraising, we can see who our fundraisers are, our top donors over here, for example, which is going to be a little tricksy. So our most generous person over here is Shane Morgan, who's an environmentalist and socialist. So we'll see if we can keep him happy, but I don't know. Here we have retired people and liberals, socialist commuter, that's two socialists, and religious farmers over here. We got a perception here. Right now, we're not considered to be a very strong leader. I think because we're brand new, this can go up. Interestingly enough, surviving an attack on my life makes me look like a strong leader. So I think that'll go up at some point. Need more taxes, murder everyone. So there's a few ways. I mean, we could raise taxes to eliminate some of our deficit. We could look at ways. We could, in the short term, actually look to just spend more money to improve the economy and hope that that gives us better taxes later on. If we take a look at our city's, our country's population, so these over here represent all the different groups in our country, and most people belong to more than one group. And there's a little dark area in the background, it's a little hard to see, but see middle income? That little dark area is about 50%. That means about 50% of our people belong to middle income, which I guess makes sense. About 50% of our people are conservative. About, I'd call that about 60% or so are liberal, 55% over there. Well, I guess then conservative would be 45%, because liberal and conservative are opposed, and socialist and capitalist are opposed. Our country is actually very socialistic. It's 74% socialist and only 26% capitalist. Now, you can play a more capitalistic sort of approach to Democracy 3. It is harder because it's in its very nature, it is a game about running a government, and therefore playing like strictly sort of anti-government, small government, it is sort of goes opposed to the flow of the game, Handoro. So it is harder, but you can do it. But one of the things you have to do is you have to make changes slowly. Hey, Hicks, thank you very much for the resub. 2-year Twitch anniversary. Thank you very much. So if I were to do things that would specifically make capitalists happy right now, well, that would make me in a bad place with the socialists. What I need to do, if I wanted to play capitalistically, I would have to bring down the socialist population over time and increase the capitalist membership. So it's like a multi-term kind of plan. First term tends to be try to make the economy not be garbage and get reelected once. And maybe set up for long-term changes. We'll see how it goes. Religious is only about, yeah, 1/3, which is very manageable. Rexar, hey, thank you very much for the resub. Reduce immigration to zero, then use the minorities as a punching bag. Lack of immigration will give them no political power, so it's not a downside. Bar a lack of international trade. See, Omniorcus knows exactly how to play a post-Brexit government. Oh, blame the immigrants for everything. It is a classic thing. So I can't directly control immigration. But citizenship tests would be one way to do it. It requires, hey Kinka, that anyone who wants to come to our country has to know, you know, what makes our country go around, for example. That's a really good idea. Now it is going to hurt. The more sort of anti-world we are, it is going to hurt our trade quite a bit, which is not great. But it is what it is. Anyway, I think law and order, I think one of the first things we're going to want to do is... Do we already have community policing? Hey, Voxel. Because that would be in here, wouldn't it? Do I already have... Legal aid, CCTV. Oh, community policing is already there. Okay. Now, we could max that out. Again, this costs us very little. Well, I mean, it's good. It would add an extra billion. But, you know, what's £1 billion? Well, these days, not as much as it used to be. Oh. So if we do this, it does make more people liberal. It reduces unemployment a bit, but it does combat street gangs. The alcohol abuse, again, we'd need a huge amount of work to do that. Reduces crime, reduces violent crime. Like, for a billion, it's pretty good, although we're already there, so we may not want to prioritize it. CCTV is already on every street corner. We can add facial recognition to it. I don't know what people want there. Too soon. Such a sick burn. Hey, History Steve, thanks for the resub. Shots fired. demonstrate UK can live that. I think there's a way to demonstrate egalitarian and socialist paradise. Also subsidies police at max. Yeah, so I don't know what problem to tackle first. There's a lot to be said. And now, a lot of these changes take a long time. For example, if you want to start to combat the technological backwater, you need to start educating them. It takes a really long time to kick in. Right now, creationism versus evolutionism. This is actually a really good way to change a lot about your country. It's free. It pisses off the religious people a lot, but also lowers membership, right? If we're not teaching creationism at all, then fewer people will become religious. And so, and this takes 30 quarters to activate. So it takes a long time, but we will start to bring down the religious membership more and more and more. And it does combat the technology backwater, which is quite nice. Because right now where it is, it's actually increasing. So green always means increase. It doesn't mean good. It means increasing. So right now where we are, the technology backwater is increasing. Whereas if I did this, it would no longer contribute to increasing that. And actually maybe enough with every other factor to make it go away completely. If you fix the economy, you can do whatever you want later on. And that is very true. So we need 30 political capital to be able to lower that. So we can't do it right now. We could still consider passing something else. Again, you know, we may pass something a little educational. All right. How do we want to start? That's an excellent, excellent question. Import tariff, citizenship test. Yeah, that's all really fun. Technology grants are not, well, they can be pretty expensive. Small business grants can be very fun. I'm not going to lower taxes right now. I don't think I'm going to raise taxes either. Do we have an obesity epidemic? No, we don't. Oh, interesting. One of the very few countries where that's not the case. We still might want to pass one of the health food initiatives because it can keep people even healthier. And one good way, for example, to... This helps with the poverty. Health food subsidies, which are not very expensive, improve health while also increasing poor earnings pretty dramatically, which I actually like quite a bit. Yeah, Sanctimus, you like to start with early investments in education. It takes so long to produce results. I completely agree. Completely agree. You know, free school meals, free eye tests, public libraries. These are really good ways to do it. Then you've got your technology grants, your university grants. University grants can be quite expensive, of course. Human cloning research grants. Oh, that sounds like fun. Gamer Taurus, hey, thank you very much for the tip. Love your streams. If you'd run in the elections, I'd vote for you. Oh man, if it gets to the point where I start running for elections, then that sounds like a really, really bad idea. Do I have the 5p plastic bag tax? That's somewhere. I don't remember where it is. It might already be in there. It is something that you can pass. Ooh, Mars program. I think we got to go to Mars, you guys. Okay, we're going to have to make a decision soon so that we can pick something. Spend on healthcare. I mean, eye tests are good. School meals are good. They really help the poor earnings. But I think we are going to start with some long-term education. So I think we're going to strike some... oh, you know what we need? Adult education subsidies. This is very good. Very good. Because it helps boost education and also productivity. And if we're going to pass something, I'm going to go and max that out. It also combats a negative condition that can come up at some point. So we're going to start with that, then I'm going to go to next turn. We're going to get 25 political capital, which will allow me to change the evolution laws. All right. Genetically modified food proposal. Are we going to allow GM crops or ban the sale of GM foods? People, you can use your vote yay or vote nay emotes at this point. So are we going to allow genetically modified crops to exist in the UK, or are we going to ban them? So vote yay or vote nay for GM crops. You gotta use the emotes. They're literally called vote yay and vote nay. because I'm mostly going to be judging things based on the color I see. I mean, just like a post-Brexit UK, I'm going to be judging things based on color. All right, overwhelmingly yay. I see lots of greens going by in the chat. So we are definitely going to go with allow genetically modified crops. Huge benefits. Not only do you increase shelf life and thus reduce costs for settlers, but they can reduce the need for pesticides, thus meaning less harmful chemicals in use during their production. It's also possible for foods to be created with other benefits, such as improved vitamin content. Boom. We are going to allow that. Excellent. All right. I have 38 political capital. So I'm going to slide the creation versus evolution way over to the right. Hopefully we'll get rid of that technology backwater a little sooner. It will take 12 quarters to kick in properly, but it'll do that. Meanwhile, the religious people are going to hate us, but luckily the UK is not super religious, so we'll see how it goes. So, yeah, if we take a look at... where's the religious? Right over here. So, next cycle, they're going to have like a huge red mark against us. But over time, it'll take a long time, but over time their numbers will drop. So technology backwater, same thing. Once creationist versus evolution kicks in a little bit more, it takes 12 quarters to kick in fully, this green uptick will go away. And then we'll actually only have downforces between technology and science funding that will, be bringing down technology backwater. And it should eliminate. It's got to go below the green line to go away. It had to go above the red line to start. But to go away has to go below the green line. So it's really bad when these things start. Who was that? Mooli! I saw you sub or resub earlier. Thank you very much for the tip. There's no message attached, but thank you very much. All right. Close that. So we don't really have any political capital. We might be able to make a little tweak somewhere, but we'll go ahead and wait and see what the next cycle brings us. Ooh! All right. So our deficit has grown. We started at 11 billion pounds. Now we're at 14 billion. It's fine. Our polls are going up. It was 11% last time, now it's 18%. Human Rights Society says actively encourage its members to oppose the current government. Human Rights Society doesn't like us. Stop and search. There, prepare your votes. Your vote nay, yay, vote nay. There are demands from the police for power to stop and search people on the street if they believe that individual may be guilty of a crime. Currently, our police cannot search someone without formally arresting them. So, are we going to be able to randomly stop a person on the street and search them? Consider this is the post-Brexit UK, and there probably will be a slight bias as to who might get stopped and searched. I'm just saying. I'm not saying what we should do in real life. I'm not saying, you know, what is right or what is wrong. I'm saying, given what we're role-playing, what might be appropriate? And overwhelmingly, the chat is saying yay. Well, I'd say it's probably something like 60-40 yay, maybe even 70-30 yay. At a quick glance, lots more greens than reds. So we are going to introduce the stop and search powers over here. Boom. Wow, we are really, really setting up a certain tone here, aren't we? So that is going to impact certain things. We might not be able to see it yet. It will show up in some of the categories. The fact that we voted stop and search, which actually won't kick in until next turn now that I'm thinking about it, will kick in here and will bring some of these categories down, but it also upsets certain groups. Not all Brexiters are racist, I know, but we're going for the sort of parody, right? The easy thing. Absolutely. There's multiple aspects. Some people are racist, regardless of what side of the Brexit thing they're on. Other people are capitalist, regardless of the Brexit side they're on. Other people are conservative, regardless of the Brexit side they're on. But, you know, we're having a laugh here. We are the you quit party. So it's a whole nother thing. Alrighty. Stop and search is already a power the UK police have. Really? Well, there you go. We're just bringing it up to the same. Get police drones so you don't get assassinated. That's not a bad idea. If we take a look over here, right now we don't have any threats because, you know, we're new. So people haven't decided that we need to be assassinated yet, but it will happen. Once that happens, we will have to enact a few more policies here to help protect us from assassination. Real Flobo, thank you very much for the 24-month resub. 2-year Twitch anniversary. Thank you very much. Okay. So we have the influence. So now if we take a look at a religious, for example, they're going to start getting crankier. Look at that. They're also cynical because of a result of maybe promises or whatever. They don't believe that we're on their side. So that's a long-term hatred of us that's going to be hard to overcome. But their membership will start to go down. Again, it'll take about 30 minutes to complete, or 30 quarters to complete the tick-in, but their membership will start to drop over time. Let's take a look at our technology backwater. Hasn't started to really move yet, which is too bad. Uncompetitive economy is on its way down, which is really good. Probably our productivity has gone up. Productivity has gone up a little, and and corporate taxes haven't changed. We could drop that. We could drop corporate taxes, which would definitely make our economy more competitive. But, of course, then we'd have less money to spend on social programs, which is a whole nother thing. Now, so far, the socialists, again, socialists make up 74% of our country. So right now, if we want to get reelected, we really have to keep the socialists happy for at least one term. Whether or not we stay more or less socialist, that's a completely separate thing. Honestly, like, you can go either way, I think, and still roleplay this sort of, like, parody, this caricature of a post-Brexit UK, which is what we're doing here. So we'll sort of have to make a decision there. It certainly will be a lot easier to go if we're somewhat more socialist. One of the interesting questions will be the liberal side of things, because they are definitely not in favor of things like stop and search. They're also going to be really against too many limitations of the, you know, rights of immigrants and so on and so forth. Hey, Sophie. Thank you very much for the resub. So we'll have to figure out where we're going there on the liberal versus conservative front. We do have more liberals currently, and their happiness went up, I guess because they like the creationism versus evolution. But for now, we're mostly looking for two things. Fix the economy, get reelected at all costs. That's the only thing that really matters at this time, plus make some role-playing decisions here and there. All right, so we have some political capital. I could go and tweak some sliders. Often it's probably better to go and just pass some more things. I mean, we don't want to pass too many expensive things, but some of these things really help us in the long run. They can really, really help us in the long run. Vertical farming is interesting. Green electronics. Government subsidies for unions. Well, if we really want to help the socialists. Rasko, thank you very much for the resub. Also, I think we just got a tip in from Oil Bucket. Just make the UK communists. Since they're doomed anyway, might as well tip them over the edge. Well, we'll see. That's certainly possible. Raise the petrol tax. Now, that's quite interesting, because one of the big problems we have is the asthma epidemic, which actually is slightly on its way down, probably because our GDP isn't as good. The environment, a good GDP actually hurts the environment. So when your economy tanks, there's less people flying and driving and everything, so the environment gets better. But yeah, the asthma epidemic comes around a lot. Car usage is one of the big factors in there. Car usage is on the way down a little bit as well. If we did increase the petrol tax, then we could make a lot of money. And it would lower car usage. In fact, we can pay a lot. Now, this can lead to, like, Huggin plus Munnin, thank you very much for the resub. We actually can't do it right now. We're very close. Mammoth, the red bubbles don't give you deficits. That's not where you lose the money. Those are bad conditions. Those are negative conditions, and we are fighting them. Don't worry about it. The Shub, thank you very much for the tip. Random Quillotine Creates donation, thank you very much. Looking forward to future videos. Sent an email tutorial request, I hope you'll consider, and vote yay for EU quit. Let me move my head to the right. It's covering too many things. Okay, let's do that. There we go. So we don't have the political capital to raise the petrol tax right now. There's other taxes we could put in. We have to be careful about that, certainly. Oh, there's the plastic bag tax. There you go, let's do it. Plastic bag tax. I mean, we're not going to raise much money, actually. It helps the economy a bit, but... I still like the health food subsidies. You know what? I'm going to pass them. Because look at this. It increases health, it improves poor earnings, it's actually very good, and doesn't cost us that much. It's actually a very good thing to pass. Mookie Moogle! To combat poverty, should abolish the NHS. If they can't afford the healthcare to save themselves, then, well, no more poor people. Jesus Christ! That's brutal! Oh, man. So, I mean, okay, so we're not going to really deal with the alcohol abuse. We're going to pretty much lead in there. At ghettos, which is being caused heavily by street gangs and the vigilante mob. So we really have to deal with this. We really have to deal with this. Poverty and unemployment is the biggest cause of street gang. Okay, yeah. I mean, we could pass a curfew. That's another way of doing it. Vigilantes, mostly caused by high crime. Crime is pinned. and brought down somewhat by police force and CCTV. And it's being, so you get that cycle. Yeah, organized crime. Maybe one of the best things to do is actually increase our intelligence service. Oh, they're really expensive, though. Upsets the liberals, but brings down crime and organized crime. What else can we do for law and order that might help without being ridiculous? Oh, we don't have any wiretapping yet. Ooh, we should do some wiretapping. Issue tasers, police drones. What do we think? Criminalized crime, yeah. It'll be illegal to be a criminal. So then we don't have crime anymore. Make a police state. Goddamn spy satellite network to fight crime. Yeah. Spy agencies are pretty great. Wiretapping horrifies liberals. Drones, tasers, oh my god. Robocop! I want a Robocop mod! Yay for wiretapping. Tasers, tasers, rah, rah, rah. A lot of people want tasers. I guess we'll deploy some tasers. Rim Pendragon, thank you very much for the resub. As usual, Twitch is probably going to lead me down a bad road. But, you know, that'll be okay. Needle exchange program to reduce poverty. It's cheap, too. Conservatives don't really like it, but... what was that? That was... oh! Japs1285, thank you very much for the tip. Institute in state an annual purge night. All right, everyone wants tasers, so we're gonna taser. Wow, that really does, you know, again, that upsets the liberals. Ubiquitous. We're just gonna taser everyone. If you like jaywalk, tasered. So there you go. So that'll reduce crime and violent crime. And that used all my political capital, so we'll go to the next turn and see what kind of effect this has. Ooh, a superhero has arrived. It's Taser Man. Taser Man. Already a number of high-profile arrests have been unofficially attributed to a masked stranger. Sign of how bad things have become on our streets, that our citizens are turning to superheroes for help. Look at this! This is a free bonus! Oh, that's excellent. Our credit rating was downgraded, which is actually really bad. Because that does directly hurt the GDP, but not only that, it increases the interest rate. You can see here the black bar over here is our interest rate, which just went up. And as a result of that, even though, I mean, partially it's our debt has grown, but also, if we... debt interest over here. So now we're paying more per month on debt interest. So, and that's going to keep going if our things decrease. We'll see how it goes. But, let's take a look. Vigilante mobs just dropped like crazy. Thump. Because of various effects. Street gangs still there. And this is organized crime won't be touched by tasers, that's for sure. So the tasers are mostly influencing, right, crime, which dropped a whole bunch, as well as violent crime, which dropped down to the ground. Whoop! There we go, no more violent crimes! And so if we let this run for a couple more cycles, I'm willing to bet that eliminates some of our problems. I mean, if this drops some more, we may actually just eliminate vigilante mobs altogether, which is going to probably help reduce ghettos dramatically, right? Vigilante mobs. Street gangs will still be an issue, which is mostly poverty and homelessness, which we really have to see if we can't resolve some of this. Deficit's grown a little bit, but not too much, actually. Normally, my economy tanks a lot more than this when I start passing things. Now the guns. What do people want with the guns? Handgun laws? So, no limits, increases violent crimes, make patriots happy. Or I can go the other way around. Total ban, which decreases violent crime. But upsets liberals. You have to remember that. Like, liberals actually, in the strictest sense of the way, want, like, less government control here, right? So, some of these things might not be exactly what you expect. Parents would be very happy. Free guns for all. Ban guns, free guns for all, ban all guns, no limits. Oh my god, the chat's very divided. We may just have to leave it where it is for now and make another glance. Doctor strike, what are you mostly upset about? Actually, unemployment is bringing this down. The wages and this and the private health care. State health services. So unemployment is, right, which makes sense. If there's a lot of unemployment, people are happier about their jobs. We have to get rid of this goddamn doctor strike. How are we going to do that? Tax the bullets. Subsidize the guns, tax the bullets. Yeah, that unemployment's really bad. That's poverty. That's not what I'm looking for. Unemployment. Right, the sleeping people. It's really bad. We could spend more on the military, or maybe we spend more on state health services. That'll bring it down. It's really expensive, though. This is our biggest expense. Still don't have enough to change the petrol tax. Tase the doctors. Tank economy, unemployment goes up, no more doctors strike. There's probably something in, like, welfare or something, or public services that will also contribute to the doctors being happier. But I don't know what that might be. I mean, I suppose I could change my, where would that be? Labor laws. Right? Go pro-employer. That would help bring down the, Now, this will upset the socialists a lot, obviously. But if I did this, that would help to combat the doctor strike. Quilt, when you figure out how to stop the doctor strike, please actually tell the UK government. It's a really annoying issue at the moment. All right. Alcohol awareness program. No, we're aware that there's alcohol. Trust me, they drink plenty of it. Letting Twitch chat vote probably isn't the smartest choice. Well, I mean, we let normal people vote all the time, and that's not necessarily the smartest choice either, but, you know, that's democracy. Make being unemployed a crime. I mean, we could do forced work. That's one of the things we can do. A compulsory work for the unemployed. That's an idea. Making striking illegal. You know what? I think we're going to go ahead and, we won't make striking illegal, but yeah, we're going to do this. Now, this will piss off all the socialists a little bit. So, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go halfway between balanced and pro-employer, right? Right around here. So that'll bring down the doctor strike. Also lowers wages. But increases productivity! Because we're increasing our working week dramatically. There we go. Done. Oh, freedom of information requests. So, do we want to propose the Freedom Act to let, like, journalists and stuff request information from the government, or do we want to reject it? So we want a yay to the freedom of information, or nay. Rejecting it makes us technically more secure against spying and whatnot. But yay makes the liberals especially happy, plus some other things. Pretty yay. Yeah. Not as extreme as some of the others, but probably still around 55 to 60% yay. Ooh, big string of nays there. Oh, it's pretty close. I don't want to straw poll it, though. I want this by acclamation. Big string of nays. Don't spam too much. Only use one icon as well. It'll decrease the chance that you'll get timed out. Looks like slightly in... Oh, that's a bunch of nays again. I'm going to flip a coin. I need a coin to flip. I don't have a coin to flip. Crap. I'm going to go yay. We're going to propose the Freedom Act. It'll help to balance some of the things we're doing to upset the liberals. There you go. It's freedom of information. So they're not quite as pissed so far. Alrighty. So, what did I want to check? Yes, okay, unproductive economy is on its way down. Good. Doctor striking is on its way down. In fact, we'll go away! We'll have resolved the doctor strike next time. So that's how you do it. You make striking illegal and it's fine. I mean, you just declare that healthcare is a vital service and they're not allowed to strike. And the government mandates their rules. It's not very nice, but there it is. Okay, vigilante mobs still drop, but not as much as we might like. Probably want more CCTV cameras. It's not very expensive either. Not even in political capitals. So that's an idea. And yeah, once the vigilante mobs and street gangs go away, it'll help. Street gangs actually went up a bit. Well, I think, here's what I think. I think once we get rid of uncompetitive economy and technology backwater, which is still going to take a while. Oh, I got to put in those freaking, more of those science grants or whatever. Technology grants. What's the other thing? Stem cells. Stem cells. Do we have stem cells? Stem cell research tends to be a really good way to eliminate some of this stuff. Oh, we need, how much do we need for this? 45 political capital to introduce. This is really powerful, not that expensive. I think we should save our power to pass this. Really, really, really valuable to help some of the technology stuff. Upsets the religious people, but, you know, we're already working our way there anyway. Membership is slowly going to start to decrease. Cut military spending so it cuts off your... No, but if we do that, we'll have too much unemployed. The deficit is growing, though. I will give you that. Doctor strike is now at an end. Hooray! Debt protection law. Okay, so... companies that are going after people with debt, do we let them sort of like harass people and go after them because this is money that is owed and capitalists will be happy about that? Or do we limit agency activity and say, listen, you're not allowed to like harass the hell out of people just because they're behind on their payments. You know, you can't extort them with crazy interest rates. This will make probably the liberals and the socialists happy. I don't know about the liberals, maybe, but the socialists will be happier. And our country is 75% socialist still. Again, that may change later on. Oh, people are wanting yes. Yes to the debt protection law. Debt protection law is yay. All right, done. So, limit agency activity. Boop, done. Okay, Dr. Strike is at an end, which is going to help health and make parents happier. You can see there was an uptick in the parent mood over here. Boop, done, done, done. So we've resolved that. We may change the labor laws again in the future. If we brought them back to balanced, it shouldn't restart the doctor's strike, which would be quite nice. Now, we don't have enough political capital. Our maximum is 38. Shit. So we actually can't have enough political capital to pass the stem cell research. Not unless we reshuffle the cabinet to get something a lot more powerful. So I think we're going to have to wait for it for now. Deficit dropped a bunch. Look at that. It's only $11 billion now. It was $18 billion last turn, so that's a big improvement. Uncompetitive economy continues to drop as well, and it's on the way to go away. Productivity is going to rise. Look at this. I mean, the labor laws, yes, but improved health is also going to make a big difference there. Industrial automation. Oh, yeah, as a factor of technology. Human cloning grants. Human cloning grants. That's fucking expensive! Religious enraged, rich prospective parents hope to make the dream of replicating themselves true. I think we're gonna have to wait on that. Maybe some public libraries. Everyone will be happy by this. And it does have a long-term impact on... Actually, it doesn't even take that long. It has an almost immediate impact on education and equality. And in literally an instant impact on the retired. So that's, there we go. So it's, okay. All right, so we're going to add another $4 billion a quarter for this, but more education is really good. More quality will also eliminate some of our problems a wee bit. I like libraries. Libraries are cool. Let's go and get our free school meals as well. Oh, that's pretty expensive, but we'll dramatically drop poverty, which also helps problems, and over the next 16 quarters, we'll improve health as well. So I'm going to do this. Spending money. Yay! Those are some of my favorite policies, though. They really, really, really do well. We could do the technology colleges. University grants are so expensive. But they are like a really good long-term investment. Are there not like, is university, I guess I'm thinking of like basically every other part of Europe where like university is free. Is university not free or subsidized in the UK? Have you gone minimum state pension yet? Nope. I should consider reshuffle. So reshuffle will come real soon. Real, real soon. Yeah, tax the junk food would be a good balance to our other... We've got the health food subsidized. So we tax the junk food and subsidize the health food. This does help the poor, hurt poor earnings and increase poverty, but... And it doesn't really make much money, but it also increases health, which is another huge, awesome investment. So yeah, there'll be a huge tax on junk food. I like it. Cut the unemployment benefits, can only immigrants are unemployed. That does sound like the you quit thinking a little bit. I don't know. We can consider doing something like that. Do the welfare fraud department, which everyone apparently in our country loves, even though it doesn't really help that much. Hamlin, thank you very much for the tip. Can we give the poor jobs pulling rickshaws? It should definitely improve public transit. Everybody wins. Oh, that's really funny. Small business grant is good. Yeah. Actually, it is pretty good. Very popular as well. Business startup campaign is really cheap and very popular. National business campaign. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to start with the business startup campaign. It drops socialist membership, makes more people self-employed, makes the self-employed happy, and the capitalist a bit happier. It really doesn't cost us that much. Start to slowly drop socialism over time. It doesn't upset anyone, so that's why the popularity is high. Supply changes. How much money do I have to spend? I have infinite money to spend. I can just print more money. What are you talking about? Sure, there might be certain implications in terms of inflation and credit rating. But yeah, so right now I'm running a deficit. Just a small deficit. It's fine. We're okay. Anyway, I'm pretty basically out of political power. So yeah, I think there might be a reshuffle real soon. Oh no, a stress epidemic has started. Businesses are working people too hard. Oh no! I should have changed the work laws before this kicked in. That's really bad. Where's the stress epidemic? It should be one of the red things, and I don't see it. Is leading to dangerously high levels of stress. Calls for limits. So what we're going to do at this point is I'm going to swing the labor laws back to balanced. Because this should not restart the doctor's strike. And it'll shrink the working week back down to something more reasonable. It's going to use a lot of political power, but I think we're going to have to do it because it'll probably develop a bad situation. And that's all our political capital, just like that. Let's take a look. Uncompetitive economy is no longer dropping. That's too bad. Technology backwater is slowly dropping. But things are going to kick in at some point. Damn, that was a really unproductive turn, but hopefully we avoid... Oh, fracking! Are we pro-fracking or against fracking? This is hydraulic fracturing. Basically, you drill and then you pump sort of like a liquid slurry into the ground, and that causes some of the rocks in the bedrock to crack a little bit, releasing natural gas. So it gives you a way to get natural gas from areas where you couldn't before. But some environmentalists have concern about this project. So are we yay for fracking or nay for fracking? Very yay. Eh, string of nays. But mostly pro. Drill, baby, drill. Nope. All right. I'm going to allow fracking at a glance then. Boom. Done. So again, the environmentalists are really... Actually, environmentalists love us right now. I don't know why. Between the GM food proposal and the fracking, they are not going to be happy. But there's only 18% of our population. At some point, they're probably going to consider starting to assassinate me. No one's been radicalized yet, so that's good. Also, the tasers are going to help with our security a little bit. It's pretty ineffective still, but... You know, maybe soon in the long run. Frack, yes. All right. So we're going to allow fracking, which actually will help our economy a little bit in a few different ways. Uncompetitive economy is actually bouncing back up because of our labor law changes. But with better education and more productivity, we should be able to improve that. So education, health. Alcohol consumption is one of the things bringing down our productivity. But I don't know. Maybe we can bring down the alcohol consumption. I mean, it's crazy. We're talking about the UK. I mean, whew, Greenpeace assassinating Quill. Yeah, that might happen. That Scottish oil you're stealing. Oh, oh, my deficit has dropped. Look at this. The debt continues to grow a little bit, but the deficit is dropping, which is really, really, really good. We might end up with a balanced budget at some point. How is our debt interest? That has gone up. And I'm just hoping we don't get another credit rating downgrade. How is the world economy? That's actually a really important question. Global economy our global economy is actually tanking. Look at this. Our deficit, is dropping. We are getting closer to balancing our books. And our GDP, which is the golden number, okay, it's pretty static. But our GDP is pretty static while the world economy as a whole is tanking. Once the global economy recovers, like, we're clearly doing really well for ourselves here. Because our economy is not crashing alongside the world. Clearly exiting the UK, or the EU, exiting the UK. Exiting the EU is clearly the right decision, because we're decoupling ourselves from this train wreck of a global economy. And we will position ourselves to become world leaders as soon as everything bounces back. Or something. Clearly Brexit was a smart vote. There you go. So I think it's time for a cabinet reshuffle. Yeah, some of these guys really not giving us power. We need to get a maximum of at least 45 so we can do the stem cell thing. So let's spend 10 capital to reshuffle the cabinet. We need a foreign policy advisor. So what we're looking for is for people with the highest possible political capital that they will give us. And ideally, we'd like to get them in the right category so that they will stay happy. It also helps. Well, their sympathies is a little odd because ideally, we would like their sympathies to be with a group that likes us so that they will stay happy. On the other hand, we can use them to boost a group that maybe doesn't like us too much, because those groups will be happy if we hire someone. But anyway, I think we're going to get Connie Price over here. She's very loyal right now. 4.6 political capital is great. She wants to get involved in foreign policy, so we're going to do that. Farmers and environmentalists will be the link. We'll see what we can do about that. But we'll get, Katie or Connie? Connie. All right, welfare minister. So again, we're just going to look for welfare 3.7, welfare 4.9. That's going to be pretty good. Farmers and parents. Economy. So this is the Ministry of Economy. Economy 4.5, pretty good. I mean, there might be others, but I'm not going to, you know, literally go through the list and to find the top. See, actually, there's 4.9 economy. All right, you. Our chancellor for taxes, 4.5. 4.6 for taxes. Looks like 4.6 for taxes is the best. Public services. Public services, 4.8. There we go. Arnold King. Law and order minister. Let's find those big numbers. 3.8. Hang on. Law and order, 4.5. Let's get you. And our transportation minister, 4.8. Are you transportation? No, you're not. You. So 3.7 for transportation. Is that our best transportation? Another 3.7? Oh, you have sympathies of ethnic minorities. I think we'll pass on that one. Okay, let's get Jeff Powell over here. Okay. So once it spends a month, we'll find out what our new maximum amount is. But we are going to make more capital per turn. And your maximum base is, I believe, a ratio of your how much you actually earn. So that'll get us there. Now, we don't have much political capital this time, so we may as well just hit the next button and see what we end up with. Appoint a UN ambassador. Okay. We have to make a choice here. We've got Kathy Rogers, who is a patriot. We'll fight tooth and claw to get our interests represented as the UN. Popular choice among patriotic, more conservative citizens, historically against foreign aid and supporter of import traffics. Not popular internationally. Or we can appoint Herman Patterson, who's a popular figure in international stage, representing reputation for solving difficult problems through compromise and understanding. A true internationalist, he is popular with liberals and socialists in our society, as well as foreign leaders. I'm not even going to vote for this, because we are going with the we are the EU quit party. So we are going to with Kathy Rogers and say UK first and only. Boom. So that's actually a really bad choice to make most of the time. Really bad choice to make most of the time, because it is going to hurt our foreign relations, which is going to have huge impacts on foreign racial tension, tourism, international trade. International trade was on its way up, but it's probably going to start dipping down, which is really bad. Our currency strength. Our currency is pretty much crap right now. Amazing. It's just like in real life. GDP is starting to uptick a little bit as more of the things get processed in, which is good. Uncompetitive economy, again, is a little static. Technology backwater is going to drop over time, but we still need to get a little bit better. You know what? We need to boost our science funding. Yes, it's expensive as hell. Really expensive. But you know what? It's worth it. It's worth it. We're going to go from about $6 billion a quarter to about $20 billion a quarter. We're going to add $14 billion to our deficit here. But it's a big boost to technology over 16 quarters, big boost to energy efficiency over 12 quarters, big boost to GDP over 20 quarters, but it directly boosts our GDP in addition to indirectly boosting our GDP. It also dramatically drops our technology backwater over 16 quarters. This is going to be really expensive. Really expensive. Boom. Let's do it. Actually, did I have enough funding for the stem cell? I may have. We just want an aerospace contract. Dropping unemployment, improving GDP. Shabam. Global economy is still in recession. It's flatline, but you see our relative GDP is going up. Things are getting better. Deficit did just grow, but there we go. 62 political capital. Thank you very much. We are going to go and pass our stem cell research right now. It's not popular with anyone. Mostly it's going to upset the religious, but it directly boosts our GDP over time while boosting health. It immediately boosts technology, which is fantastic, and it's really not expensive. Pass that. Ba-ba-bow! Quillotine, you just changed your cabinet. Meanwhile, the opposition can't hire people to fill the roles. Oop, that's not where I want to go. I want to go over here. So there's still... So, the EU Rocks Party... activists to boost turnout. So they've got their activists out there working to try to boost their turnout. We've got no one in our party yet. We don't have that sort of passion. Campaign funds over time. The opponents are getting an increasing amount of it. We're going to wait until like closer to the election time to do media stunts. How did we flip-flop on promises? We haven't made any promises yet. Everything's getting better. You have to re-elect me. Oh my god, my popularity is shit. All right, we're going to have to start sucking up to people. That will probably be the next of things we do. The liberals, who again are making up a large percentage of our population, and our socialists as well. If we can please them, we can probably get back in. Motorists are a large percentage of our population too, and I don't know if we can really help them. Actually, we could. If we go... They like... They like, obviously not carbon tax, there's something you can do to, oh, probably under transport. It's not car emission limits, it's fuel efficiency standards they actually like, because they want more fuel efficient cars. So I'm going to pass this. It see, increases motorist income. Okay, it doesn't make them directly happy, but increases their income. Lowers oil demand. It upsets capitalists a little bit, but that's it. Only upsets... it increases car usage. But also drops CO2 emissions. I'm gonna pass this. I must activate pander mode. Yep. Fabricate a claim on the liberals. Anti-gravity research grants? Listen. It's fine. Capitalists want to kill me. Ban same-sex marriage. No, we're gonna allow same-sex marriage. You know what? That's good for the economy. More weddings. People spend more money. And it's dumb to not. Just some things just don't make sense. Okay, our relative GDP did drop a scooch. But that's alright. Interest rates are static. Global economy is starting to maybe bounce back. Our deficit grew, but now see it's shrinking again. We're actually going in the right direction. Technology backwater is dropping. Uncompetitive economy bounced back again, but I think we'll get back there. Asthma epidemic still where it is. How's our overall health, though? Health is on its way up. See, I like that a lot. High health improves productivity. So as more and more of these things keep kicking in and health continues to improve, it's actually really good for us. Getting rid of the doctor strike made a big difference. And you can see here, junk food tax, free school meals, big difference. The health food subsidies trigger over time. Health food subsidies still got some quarters left to fully kick in, but it's going to have a big boost to a lot of our stuff. Plus, a more competent cabinet is really good. Make same-sex marriage mandatory. Ban marriage for everyone. I like when we played the quillessentialist play with Essentia, and we're playing like the religious theocracy. We still allowed same-sex marriage, but we banned divorce. You can marry anyone you want for life. And I like that one. Petrol tax. Yeah, so we've got one. We could raise it. It's not good for the economy. If we raise it, actually, until it gets really high, it doesn't really affect the GDP. We can go up to around here. You know what? Let's do it. Bam. It's going to raise a lot more money for us. Probably eliminate the deficit, actually. Oh my god, there's already an assassination attempt! The Battenberg group. Okay. Oh shit. Everyone hide! Black Power group and the Battenberg group both want us dead. But we have to go into pander mode, but I also have to go into don't die mode. Time for police drones and wiretapping. Also, we never got rid of this shit. How did we never get rid of this shit? Police drones and wiretapping. We're gonna start with police drones, because drones are cool. Police drones. Max. Actually, it doesn't really change. Nah. Maximum police drones. Everyone hide. The exchange program is probably a really good idea. It's not expensive either. And improves health over time. We're gonna have the police drones deliver needles for people. capitalist plot. A new superhero! Hey! Global economy still in recession. Having an everything impact. Polls don't look good. We're only 2% in the election. And we're not that far away. We got 4 turns until the election. Oh, we're never gonna get reelected. Look at that. We're going to eliminate all these problems, though. All right, not organized crime yet. That's what wiretapping is for. Let's get the wiretapping. Maximum. Universal monitoring. Oh, that's going to upset the liberals too much. No, fuck it. We're going to get rid of all the crime. Capitalist plot. Vigilante mobs are at an end. We have to appoint a senior judge. Pro-human rights or anti-violent crimes. Harsh sentence feels must apply to thieves. Okay. Are we going yay for the human rights? Or nay for human rights, which means we'll go for Sherry King, who's a lot more tough. Yay human rights? Or nay, we're going to be tougher. Nay, nay, nay. Little yay. Lots of nays. All right, lots of nays. We're gonna go with Sherry King. We're gonna lock down on this. Major donor abandons party. Oh fuck. We're never gonna get reelected. Oops, that's not the button I wanted. Is this button here? Oh, there we go. I can start giving speeches now. My fundraising sucks. We're gonna be. Oh, trustworthiness. We can improve. Ooh. So the one with the biggest chance of success would be the televised cabinet meeting, although the impact's a little bit lower than releasing the tax return. Maybe we can do both. It was a success! Media spin. So we're trustworthy. Can we be a strong leader? Yeah, we can drive a tank! I want to drive a tank. Yes! Okay. All right. Can we do more? Let's land an aircraft carrier. There we go. So this will go down over time, but it's good right now. Okay, we're gonna give a speech as well. Pro-socialist, boo-capitalist. They already want to assassinate me. What do they care? Pro-old people, anti-youth. Youth don't vote anyway. Yay, rich, boo, poor. We have to like up the socialists. They're a big crowd. Ooh. Oh, we can just praise motorists. And it doesn't hurt anyone. We have a lot of motorists. Let's talk about how much we love the motorists. Speech results. Show you the results of your speech illustrating how popular it is with the wide focus group of all voters. I mean, we're not upsetting anyone. We're just saying, like,
We're bringing back Top Gear for another season, and we're firing Chris Evans.
Yay! Everyone's happy by that. Woo! Chris Evans sucks. All right. There we go. Okay. It's fine. V8, V8. More power! I could have done multiples at once. Okay. Well, that would have been interesting, yeah. Can I just give another speech? Oh, no. Okay, that was my only speech. Oh, I would have needed to do more than one group at a time. Okay. And then I'm pretty basically out of points. So, next turn. Probably going to get assassinated. They don't need to assassinate me. I'm not going to get re-elected anyway. Positive discrimination. No, we're going to reject that. Because it doesn't make sense given the role-playing that we're doing here. So, this is like, What's the word? Affirmative action. Yeah, so we're going to reject that because it doesn't make sense with the role-playing that we're doing over here. Okay. So we got two turns until the election. We're now running a surplus. Can I make a promise? Just before the election. So literally the turn before. I want to do more media stunts. I gotta get reelected at this point. But there's something else. I mean, I could do something with all this money. Environmentalists love me, but there aren't very many of them. Motorists are going up. You know what I could do with the money? Is build more roads. Because that'll also lower unemployment. Quite quickly, actually. Upsets environmentalists, but again, there aren't very many of them. More taxes, or less taxes, more houses. Make another speech. I wasn't able to. No speeches. Oh, no, I can. Never mind. I'm wrong. Socialist, he's one of my big donors. Liberal, he's not particularly happy. I need to make the liberals happier. What do they look like? Self-employed, poor, patriot. I don't remember what the liberals look like. Liberal. Right, long-haired hippie freak. Can I not make a speech for him? Oh, is that him? Yeah, there we go, liberals. Assess the conservatives. It'd be nice if I could talk up the liberals without upsetting the conservatives, but it's not really possible. So could I do socialists plus liberals? And actually, that makes them both super-duper happy. Super-duper happy. And actually, can I do this as well? It looks like, I mean, reading this, it looks like this bullet point will only upset the socialists a little bit, whereas this one will make them really happy. It'll make the conservatives, or the capitalists, a little unhappy, while making these capitalists super happy. I mean, the capitalists aren't a very high population base, though. You know what? I think I'm just going to do this. Liberal, socialists. I can try to make the religious a little bit happier. I mean, I think that it maybe the more groups you put in, the more it sort of, like, weakens your core message. Oh, I can scroll down. Thanks. Well, actually, there's nothing down there. But it is nice to know there's a scroll bar. Probably would have been handier later. Maybe make commuters happier. There we go. We'll throw that in. And maybe we'll soften our message. Oh, okay, we can do up to four groups. All right, let's do four groups. Praise the religious and the commuters, since it doesn't upset anyone. And then the liberals and the socialists. At a slight cost to conservatives and capitalists, but they don't have that many people. So we choose up to four. May polarize some groups against us. Give the speech. Polling. Next section. Oh, there we go. I see. Oh, each section of the speech. All right. Cool. Want to lace the speech with double speak? It could hurt everyone. Okay, plus 24. So capitalists and conservatives down a bit. The others up quite a bit. We've got two turns until the next election. We still have no popularity. But I have fixed everything! I gotta pander my ass off. It's still the Liberals that are most disappointed. And it's not going to help. That's the problem. We're playing in the like that sort of UKIP-y style, which the Liberals don't like. Anything I can think of would probably just upset the Liberals more. And they're 70% of our base. What else can I do for Liberals? That makes sense, giving a roleplay style. Legalized drugs. It hurts organized crime as well. It does raise crime, though. Let's just legalize pot. Legalize pot. That's what we're gonna do. Oh, I can't. I don't have the points. Shit. Art subsidies? Ooh. Art subsidies. I love it. Yes! Wonderful! I love it! It will eventually improve our foreign relations and tourism and education as well. So this is actually really good to combat the fact that we are, you know, we built a giant wall. Okay, love it. Thanks for pointing that out. Next turn. Probably just gonna get assassinated. Not yet. Miracle... Okay, miracle operation, so everyone loves us. Failed an assassination attempt. From the Battenberg group. Credit rating was upgraded. Manifesto promises available. Okay. What are we going to promise? Raise the GDP by 50%. I think we could do that, actually. Our GDP is pretty low, and I think it's on the verge of improving. I could also make a pledge to raise the funding of state schools, state housing, cut poverty. Everything. Promise everything. Cut art subsidies by 25%. That wouldn't be really easy to do. Yeah, I have a 28 billion pound surplus, but I'm unpopular. Well, I mean, I'm making money, but the Liberals hate me. So I'm gonna raise the GDP. That mostly made the capitalists happy. I'm gonna raise, this is gonna make the socialists happy. I'm gonna raise the funding to state schools. Poor socialists, state employees, a little bit. I'm also gonna raise state housing by 50%. Capitalists get upset a bit, but the socialists can improve. We have a lot of socialists. That's who I have to impress. So I'm not gonna promise to cut income tax. Equality, I don't care about equality. Can I make more speeches? Oh, I can. Awesome. I'm gonna pretend that I'm compassionate. Visit a care home. And an orphanage. I leave myself with 12 points so I can make another speech. Excellent. I got a tip from Luke! Come on, Quill, you should know by watching American politics, it's not the guys who does the most who wins, it's the guy who can yell the loudest and say the craziest shit. You're absolutely right. Okay. Again, I may have to suck out to the Liberals some more short term here. Trade unionist, 40%, self-employed, 21%. So that's probably a good one to do. Who's this? Parents, because I won't upset anyone. That's not going to have much of an effect against motorists, but or with motorists. Youth people don't vote. And the Liberals are a big block. I don't know if I can make them vote for me anyway. I'm upsetting the... self-employed quite a bit if I take this route. But, you know, I'm just pandering to the biggest voting blocks there are. That's entirely what I'm doing here. Just the bigger the voting block, well, the bigger, the better. And or the effect. Rebuild Hadrian's Wall. Youth people don't vote, and it's absolutely true. Socialists, there's a lot of them. They're pretty happy as is, though. And the capitalists already hate me, so you know what? Upsetting them doesn't matter. Give a speech. I mean, the capitalists are literally trying to assassinate me, despite the giant surplus that I'm running. It goes to show you how fickle the voters will be, though. I'm, like, running this giant surplus, bringing down our debt. I fixed the vigilante mobs. Gangs are still a bit of a problem, but they're almost gone. Technology backwater is going to end on the same turn I don't get reelected. I don't have any more political capital, so I can't do anything. Yeah, and I also didn't have any money. Oh my god, we got destroyed! Alright, we're going to try this again. We're going to try a different campaign. We're going to play as Canada.